pretty cage.
Well, I don't know.
And here, I mean, this is the problem. I might. Yeah. So what does that mean? I don't know! Sorry, I just...
I know, it's true.
What did she say? Exactly.
Well...
No. What did you say?
I asked the man.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't even know you did that. You asked her to marry you!
Yes.
Yes. And she said...
Well... wanted to marry.
Right.
And she didn't answer.
Right.
See, I said, do you want to get married? And she said, sure.
Sure.
Yeah, but like really quick, like right away. So I wasn't sure
if she meant it.
Or just like in general.
As a life goal.
Right, exactly. But not a life goal, but you know, a possibility, like a career and everything. Like she definitely considered it as a viable option.
Right.
So I was like, well, do you want to marry me?
You said that.
Yeah, I said, do you want to marry me?
And
what did she say?
Nothing!
She didn't say anything! She just looked at me!
Like, I'm so in love with you. You were like deer in the headlights, weren't you?
Jesus, man! I don't know! Maybe like, she didn't hear me? She didn't hear you?
I don't know!
Well, if she didn't hear you,
she heard me.
Okay. She didn't say anything. She just looked at me, and it was like, hours, years were passing by, little calendar pages flipping, flying all around the room, and... She just looked at me for like a week.
So what did you do?
I said...
Yeah?
I said... That was okay.
That was okay?
Yeah.
And she said...
She said, okay.
What do you mean
before?
What?
said she was amazing.
Yeah.
What did she mean?
Amazing. She is.
You know.
What?
Are you fucking my fiance?
What?
For now.
For now.
promise me you won't stop looking. Okay?
Hey, Peter Finch! How's it going? Got some Oolong number 4 to your name on it, buddy. Swear to God, I listened to the G and end all G's. Lost 15 pounds drinking that stuff. So did my dad. How's it going? I'm Luke. You need tea, come see me. Peter. Oh, I know, it's the beard. It's freaking out that I shaved it. I like the freedom. It's like being caged and set free all in your own volition.
His name's not Peter Fish.
Listen, you need to ask. I have a web designer friend looking for some work. You guys aren't hiring, right? He's good. Really good. Not the best, but crazy good. He's like the film innocent of my
design. His name's not.
Actually, get this. He met his current girlfriend for you guys. He thinks matchmaking is the best thing since, I don't know, E-Army? Been together a year and a half. Should I call you or what? Email you? Oh, sorry, no, I'll come get that Oolong, man. It'll knock you on your ass. I need to get that DVD back. Tomorrow? All right? Nice to meet you.
Your name is Peter? Is that correct? Or are we looking at a schizophrenic homeless guy who just thinks he works in a tea shop? Please tell me we are looking at a schizophrenic homeless guy who just thinks he works in a tea shop. But we're not, are we?
Rachel, this means isn't what?
My thing. What's my thing? And you don't work for a clothing catalog based in Maine named after a human. You work for men. Or maybe you run. Or are somehow, in some way, associated with matchmaker.com. The website. This website. Is that what you meant? Isn't Peter Finch F-I-N-C-H like the bird?
Rachel, please just.
Peter Finch the actor. Peter Finch the golfer. Peter Finch the K-Fog DJ.
Just relax.
Or how about you, Peter Finch, a professional profile on LinkedIn.com? Might that be you?
Just please.
Should I click and see if we're moving to fucking Detroit tomorrow? How about Peter Finch's Facebook page? Or Peter Finch's MySpace page? Some of these might even have pictures.
All right.
All right, what? I'm gonna start clicking.
They threatened.
You were threatened.
There's the company's desperate. They're on the verge of. Alright, you think I wanted to do this? You didn't think that thing was wrong?
What are you?
They're desperate, alright? They're on the verge of, I don't know, fucking bankruptcy. They threatened to fire us. Fire us if we didn't. They said, we're providing hope for our clients. Hope we continue on from there. That's what they told us.
So they set out their own employees. And not just dates. Very attractive, very supportive, very encouraging dates.
Listen, you are a wonderful, clearly a wonderful with lots of. It was just to keep you, you know.
From canceling my subscription.
From giving up.
At least tell me that this is your first time. At least tell me that this is my first time.
They're not bad people, really, they're not. Neither am I. They're just...
We're going back to my place.
What?
You took advantage of me. You don't also get to counsel me on what I do and do not want.
Yes,
Look, we'll get the CEO on the phone, all right? We'll work this out. We'll refund all your money, all of it. We'll pay you triple, quadruple, whatever you want. Just please.
Okay, I mean, I know it's not cool, I know it's stupid, but they just make me smile, and that's the
Something. This next piece with the Naked Empire is not appropriate for children. Okay, I'm gonna say this again. It is not appropriate for children. If you have never said anything more than gosh darn and fudge in front of your children, this would be an excellent time for either your children to learn some new words,
yay,
or to protect them from those words and kind of go find another stage where maybe there's a clown or a juggler or someone maybe wearing a hat and a purple shirt and a purse just waiting for someone at the bus stop to pick her up and take her somewhere else. So it'd be an appropriate time for them to leave. Is there anybody else without pointing or looking around to say if anyone? My kids have heard every word. What? If they've heard the word.
Children at heart, I'm 8, lady, it's totally fine.
That's right. Gary, you're doing fine. Is that everyone? Because we don't want to, I think like the word is going to be there. Did I say that fuck? That word's going to be there? Fuck, that word fuck. You're going to hear the word fuck, is that right? There you go. Now you're done. You're just dallying in it. But that word's going to be said. Is the other word going to be said? The C word, commitment, is that going to be said? The C word, yeah. Well, there, that one. That's right, because I'm divorced. This is the face of after.
They're not here.
God bless you. You can watch.
They're drumming.
I'm going to
can't do as good as you, though.
Howard wants me to kill time. How are you guys doing?
Yeah.
All right, you guys are lively for sitting in the sun all day. That's nice. You're doing good. And the pasty white people are about to burst into flames with the maps on top of their heads, but you guys are doing good. And so protect your arms too, sir, because I don't want to have to put you out before the end of my set. My name is Eric Cash. I'm originally from New Orleans, Louisiana. I used to have a joke about that, but FEMA screwed that all up, so never mind. I moved to San Francisco because apparently I wasn't very comfortable being able to afford my rent. This place is awesome. There's these people all over the country that think there's so many gay people in San Francisco, but most of them don't realize that over half of them weren't gay until they moved here. They're trying to pay their bills. $2,700 a month for this piece of crap? Oh my God, there's only one choice left. Hand me the hot pink booty shorts and the for sale sign. You guys over here, you can laugh. It's okay. You're kind of like the Helen Keller crowd right now. You're not really laughing. You're just kind of typing on your hands. It's okay, guys. You can laugh at Helen Keller. She can't hear you. Oh, come on. Even if she did, what's she going to say? And don't you owe me. They traumatized me with that film when I was 7 years old. They make you watch that movie. 7 years old. Oh, and now you're going to see Helen Keller. She's an American icon. She's an American icon. It's horrible. I can't believe they made me go through that. Hang on, just a second. Okay, it's just an ambulance. Don't worry, we're safe now. It's all right. When you see a really fat person wearing camouflage, you ever just want to walk up and start hanging ornaments on them? Not to be mean, just to make a point, you know, you're fat, that's fine. Camouflage? We can see you. You just look like a forest. The other day, these I was hanging out the window of my apartment shooting at the homeless. Not to be mean, I just wanted to shoot at something that might actually die. I've been shooting pigeons for 2.5 weeks, and I don't know if you know this, but when you shoot a pigeon, it doesn't die. It just splits into two pigeons and flies off. It's ridiculous. You're not solving the problem. You're just adding to it. I'm pretty sure there's a guy out there that has both ADD and OCD, but you've never seen him. He can't leave the house because he's never sure how many times he's opened the door. 1, 2, hey, what's that? God damn it! Are we ready to bring these guys on? You ready to bring them on? All right, you bring them up. Let's hear for Cash, everybody. Slipping in there doing that. Are we ready for your final piece here at the East, where are we, the East Garden?
Yeah.
No, no, no. Are you ready? Welcome, the stage manager and the creator, arts genius behind this whole fucking thing. Can we say fuck?
Yeah.
Fucking thing.
Fuck yeah.
I'm making that by a Buffon.
Let's hear it. All right, thank you guys so much for coming on out. I'm Nathaniel. This is the Naked Empire Buffon Company. What you're about to see is an excerpt from our full-length production called Shame, which opens at Mama Calizo's Voice Factory on August 20th. Again, you know that people who might be sensitive to profanities and profane imagery should probably leave or be introduced to something new. Welcome them to the stage.
Oh,
Doug, 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 Doug.
Insist for this labor, imitation, buy from reputed dealers only.